Hello everyone. I, Mrs. Deepa Kamble from SC Union High School and Junior College, welcome you all to this session of CET preparation. Today, we will be revising the lesson Life Processes in Living Organism, Part 1 from Science and Technology, Part 2. So let's start. With your 10th standard result declared, already you have your marks in your hand. The next step is your preparation for the CET. So this session is going to help you for the same. Let's start, children. We'll first define life processes. When organisms perform metabolic activities like nutrition, respiration, growth, excretion, reproduction, sensitivity, and locomotion for living, these activities are called as life processes. There are various systems that continuously perform their function in human body. Along with the various systems like digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system, excretory system, and control system, different external and internal organs perform the functions independently but through complete coordination. For this, there is a continuous need of energy, and this energy we get from carbohydrate, fats, lipids. Carbohydrate, fats and lipids are the main source for this energy. But how the living organism produce the energy? So we are going to study how the living organism produce the energy. This energy is produced by the living organism by the process of respiration. We'll define respiration. The oxidation of foodstuff to produce energy is called as respiration. There are two levels of respiration: body level for exchange of gases, cellular level for oxidation of glucose and production of energy. At the body level, the exchange of gases takes place. Exchange of which two gases takes place? Oxygen and carbon dioxide. When the diaphragm contracts, the air enters the nostril, then it enters the larynx. Through the larynx, it enters the trachea. Through the trachea, it will enter the two bronchii. Through the bronchial, this air enters the bronchioles, and then it enters the alveoli. What are alveoli? They are air-filled sacs, which are present, empty sacs, which are present in the lungs. You will see this alveoli are near the, or you will see they are, this sac are surrounded by a dense network of blood vessel. The air which is present in the alveoli, that is the oxygen which is present in the alveoli, will enter the blood which is present in the blood vessel surrounded by the alveoli. The carbon dioxide which is present in the blood will enter the alveoli, and then it will be exhaled out by the body. The stages of respiration. There are two stages of respiration: breathing process or external respiration, which is further, you will see there are two steps in that, that is inhalation and exhalation. Cellular respiration, which is also called as internal respiration, it has two steps, which is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Cellular respiration. Oxidation of glucose takes place inside the cell of the living organism, which is called as the cellular respiration. There are two methods of cellular respiration. The first one is the aerobic respiration, which takes place in the presence of oxygen. Second one is anaerobic respiration, which takes place in the absence of oxygen. Aerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized in three steps. Which are the three steps? We'll see. First step is glycolysis. Second step is tricarboxylic acid cycle. Third step is electron transport chain reaction. Glycolysis. This is the first step, so we'll see in detail. Breakdown of glucose in pyruvic acid is called as glycolysis. Glyco means glucose and lysis means breakdown. It occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. This process of glycolysis, it takes place in the cytoplasm of the cell. Please remember this point, children. Glucose is oxidized step by step to produce two molecules of pyruvic acid, ATP, NADH2 and H2O. So in this process, you will see two molecules each of pyruvic acid is formed, ATP, NADH2 and water. Molecules of pyruvic acid are then converted into two molecules of acetyl coenzyme A. Two molecules each of NADH2 and carbon dioxide are released in this process. Tricarboxylic acid cycle or Krebs cycle. It occurs in the matrix of the mitochondria. Children, remember over here, the first process, that is glycolysis, takes place in the cytoplasm. Tricarboxylic acid cycle or Krebs cycle, it takes place in the matrix of the mitochondria. You can see the diagram also over here. You will see that Krebs cycle takes place in the mitochondria. The first stable compound formed in this process is a 3-carbon compound, which is called as citric acid. So the cycle is called as tricarboxylic acid cycle. Tri means 3. The first compound formed is a 3-carbon compound. It is also called as the citric acid cycle. Sir Hans Krebs discovered all the cyclic reactions of TCA cycle, so it is also known as Krebs cycle. Acetyl coenzyme A formed enters the mitochondria and gets oxidized into molecules of carbon dioxide, water, NADH2 and FADH2. Now from where this acetyl coenzyme is formed, you have seen in glycolysis, acetyl coenzyme, the pyruvic acid gets converted into acetyl coenzyme A. So the acetyl coenzyme A enters the mitochondria in this process, and then the oxidation takes place, and then carbon dioxide, water, NADH2 and FADH2 is formed. The third step, electron transport chain reaction. It occurs in the inner mitochondrial membrane containing the protein complexes. NADH2 and FADH2, which are the reducing powers, participate in this reaction. During this reaction, 3 ATP molecules are obtained from each molecule of NADH2. Two ATP molecules are obtained from each molecule of FADH2. Water molecule is also formed as one of the end product in this process. Over here you will see the overall equation of aerobic respiration. Glucose plus oxygen gives carbon dioxide, water, and energy is liberated. Energy currency of the cell. Adenosine triphosphate is the energy rich molecule, and it is the molecule which gives us the energy. You will see over here it is made up of three parts. Which are that three parts? We will see. ATP is formed from adenine. This is the first part. Then ribose sugar and 3-phosphate groups. The energy is stored in the bonds present between the phosphate group. Whenever the body needs the energy, energy is derived by breaking the phosphate bonds of ATP. You will see over here the phosphate bonds will break and then energy is given. Hence ATP is called as the currency, energy currency of the cell. And anaerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized in the absence of oxygen and energy is released. There are two steps which are involved in this process. First one is the glycolysis and second one is fermentation. Energy from different food components we get, as you know that we need energy, and this energy we get from the food that we eat. But the excess of carbohydrate that we get or that are present in our body are stored in the liver and muscles in the form of glycogen. Whatever energy is required for the different life processes, it will be utilized and extra will be stored. Amino acids are obtained after the digestion of protein. Those amino acids are absorbed by the body and transported up to each organ and cell via blood. From this amino acid, organs and cell produce various proteins necessary for themselves and whole body. We'll see the uses of amino acids. Amino acids are used by the skin to make melanin, it is a pigment, and keratin, it is a key structural material of skin and horns. They are also used by the bones to make osin, a collagen component of bone. They are used by the cells to make proteins of cell membrane and in synthesis of various enzymes. Pancreas will use this amino acid to synthesize insulin and trypsin. Synthesize means to prepare insulin and trypsin. Pituitary gland will use the amino acid in synthesis of various hormones. You know that pituitary gland is called as the master gland because it produces many hormones which are very, very important. By muscle cells, in synthesis of actin and myosin, which are flexible proteins, these are the proteins which are present in our muscles. By the blood, to synthesize the hemoglobin and antibodies. Now the fatty acids are obtained after the digestion of lipids. You have to remember this point, children, because these points can be asked as MCQ questions. So, second point over here, we get 9 kilocalories of energy per gram of lipids. We get 4 kilocalories of energy per gram of carbohydrate. And from proteins, from each gram of protein, we get 4 kilocalories of energy. There are various vitamins which are essential. Out of that, there are 6 main types of vitamins. A, vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E and vitamin K. Out of this, A, D, E and K, they are the fat soluble vitamins. Whereas B and C, vitamin B and C are water soluble vitamins. FADH2 and NADH2 are produced in the processes like glycolysis and Krebs cycle. These are also the important enzymes which are very, very important. Vitamins like riboflavin, that is vitamin B2, and nicotinamide, vitamin B3, respectively are necessary for the production of FADH2 and NADH2. You know that water is also very, very important for our body and cell. If there is less amount of water, it leads to dehydration. So each cell contains 70% of water by weight. It is very, very essential. Now we'll move to the next part of the lesson, which is cell division. Now you know that cell undergoes division to form a daughter cell, which is called as cell division. Cell division is a very important process. Due to the cell division only, the multicellular organisms are formed. Growth will take place in the multicellular organism. If you get a wound, it will heal because of this process, that is the cell division. And a emaciated body, that is a thin body, can be restored because of cell division. A new individual is formed from pre-existing one only due to the cell division. Types of cell division, there are two types of cell division, mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis, this is the first type of cell division that we are going to study. Over here you will see that this type of cell division takes place in the stem cell and the somatic cell or the body cell. Only in these two types of cell the mitosis will take place. It undergoes two steps, that is first step is the karyokinesis, that is division of nucleus, cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm and the whole cell. Now karyokinesis takes place in 4 different stages, which is then followed by cytokinesis, that is the division of nucleus takes place in 4 different stages. Which are that stages that we'll see? The first stage over here is prophase. In the diagram, children, you will see over here in this first phase, condensation of the chromosomes takes place with the sister chromatin, and you will see over here the chromatin initially is in the form of fibers. They will start condensing in this stage. The centrioles will duplicate and move towards the opposite poles. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to disappear at this stage. Second stage over here you will see is metaphase. Over here nuclear membrane completely disappears. You will see the nuclear membrane starts to disappear in the prophase, but when you come in the metaphase you will see that the nuclear membrane will now completely disappear. The chromosomes which are formed will arrange themselves in the equatorial plane of the cell. You will see in the diagram how the chromosome arrange themselves in the equatorial plane. This is the distinguishing character of this phase. You can recognize the stages of the cell division. So if you want to, finding the different stages, you will see in metaphase. If the cell is in the metaphase stage, the chromosomes are arranged in the equatorial plane. Spindle fibers and the astral fibers are formed by the centrioles. You will see the yellow colored fibers that are present over here, children, are the spindle fibers. You will see these are the spindle fibers. They get attached, the spindle fibers get attached to the centromere of the chromosome and they will form the spindle apparatus. So this is the metaphase, the distinguishing character you will remember. They chromosome align themselves in the equatorial plane. Anaphase. In the anaphase, you will see that the centromere splits as the spindle fibers undergo contraction. See over here, the spindle fibers are undergoing the contraction. As a result, the sister chromatid separates and are pulled towards the opposite poles. See over here, slowly they are moving towards the opposite pole. The separated sister chromatids and chromatids are the daughter chromosome. Now the next step, that is the telophase. The daughter chromosomes start to decondense to form chromatin reticulum. Nuclear membrane, see, in the prophase, nuclear membrane and nucleolus, they start disappearing, and in this phase, they are formed around the newly formed chromatin reticulum. Spindle fibers, they completely disappear in this stage. Cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means the division of the cytoplasm. In the plant cell, you will see that it takes place, cytokinesis takes place by the formation of cell plate. Over here you can see a cell plate is being formed. The cell plate from the center of the cell to the periphery, and this cell plate will divide the cell into two daughter cells. See, two daughter cells are formed. In case of animal cell, a central notch is formed which deepens towards the center and then divides the cell into two daughter cells. So cytokinesis, you will see in plant cell the cell plate is formed, and in case of animal cell a notch is formed. Meiosis. This is the second type of the cell division. This cell division takes place only in the germinal or reproductive cell. One cell divides to form four daughter cells called as gametes. Male gamete is called as the sperm and female gamete is called as ovum. It is also called as the reduction division. As the number of chromosome becomes half, that is, if the cell is diploid cell, it has 2n number of chromosome. It is diploid cell, it will become a haploid cell with n number of chromosome. There are two stages in this division, meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Meiosis 1, it is reduction division. The chromosome number reduces from diploid 2n to haploid. There are again two stages, karyokinesis, division of nucleus, cytokinesis, division of cytoplasm. At the end of meiosis 2, two haploid daughter cells are obtained from one diploid cell. Meiosis 1, in that karyokinesis 1, division of nucleus takes place in this stage. The first stage is the prophase. Again over here we have four phases. So the first phase is prophase, and it includes five stages: leptotene, zygotene, pachyty, diplotene and dikinesis. These are the five different stages of prophase 1 in meiosis 1. Metaphase 1. In metaphase 1, the chromosome align themselves in the equatorial plane of the cell. Spindle apparatus are formed. Anaphase, two homologous chromosome get separated and move towards the opposite poles of the cell due to the contraction of spindle fibers. As a result, reduction in the number of chromosome occurs. Telophase, there are haploid number of chromosome on both the poles of the cells. The nuclear membrane, nucleolus are formed. Cytokinesis 1. In plant cell, cytokinesis takes place by the formation of cell plate from the center of the cell to the periphery, dividing the cell into two daughter cells. In animal cell, a central notch is formed that deepens towards the center, and the cell divides into two daughter cells. You can see over here a notch is formed. Now, if you want the detailed explanation of this topic, you can find the videos on the YouTube channel Deepa Kamble SVU. So you can refer over to that, or you can see that channel for detailed explanation. Now children, The main aim for this preparation session is how you are going to appear for this CET exam. You are going to appear for this CET exam. The format of this exam is you are going to give answers to MCQ type of question, that is multiple choice questions. So now we will prepare for the MCQ in the second part. In prophase, the first question, in prophase, nuclear division dash process occurs in the cell. We have already seen, children, condensation of chromosome starts in this phase only. Centrioles duplicate and they start moving towards the opposite pole. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to disappear. All these three, you can see these three answers, first, second, third, they are correct for this first question. So your answer will be, you will select the fourth option, which says all of the above. Got it? In prophase, condensation of the chromosome also starts, centrioles duplicate and move to the opposite pole, nuclear membrane and nucleolus starts to disappear. Second question, due to dash property, a multicellular organism grows up and emaciated body can be restored. Reproduction, children, you know that it is a life process in which one living organism gives birth to the other living organism, correct? So over here you will see this will get on its own, you will eliminate it, and you have already studied that cell division is a process by which the multicellular organism grows. So your correct answer will be second option, cell division. Question number 3, dash is helpful in the digestion of other substances and ejection of undigested substances. You know that fibers, they don't take part in the process of digestion, but they are helpful for us. It helps us to remove the unwanted food, that is eject the undigested substances from the body. So your answer over here will be fibers, first option. Question number 4, in anaerobic respiration, glycolysis and dash are the two steps. So oxidation will not be the correct answer because anaerobic respiration takes place in the absence of oxygen. So the correct option over here is fermentation, that is the second option. Question number 5, dash is called as the energy currency. Options are, first option is DTP, second one is ATP, third one is OTP, and fourth one is all of the above. You know the answer. Yes, what is the answer? Obviously ATP. Question number 6, dash food components are main sources of energy. Main sources of energy, the first option is fibers, fats and carbohydrate. Second one is fibers, lipids and proteins. Third option is carbohydrate, fats and protein. And fourth one is none of the above. Now fibers, you don't know that we don't get energy, but they are useful to remove the unwanted substances out of the body. Carbohydrate, fats and protein, they are the main sources of energy. From these food components or from these nutrients, we get the energy. So the third option is the correct one, carbohydrate, fats and proteins. Question 7, in living organism, respiration occur at dash and dash at two levels. Options, tissue level, muscle level, second one, body level, cellular level, third one, organ level, cellular level, fourth one, body level and organ level. So the correct answer over here is body level and cellular level. Question number 8, carbohydrates in the food components which are taken up by our body are used mainly to get energy. This energy is stored in the form of DTP, OTP, ATP and all of the above? The answer is ATP. The third option will be the correct answer over here. Question number 9. In cellular level respiration, dash carbohydrate is oxidized step by step. In cellular level respiration, children, you remember the first step is glycolysis. In that, glucose is oxidized. So, the answer over here will be glucose. The first option is the correct one. Question number 10. Tricarboxylic acid cycle is operated on molecule of acetyl coenzyme A. Where does this cycle takes place? I have already told you. Over here the options given are nucleus, centriole, mitochondria and none of the above. So the answer, the tricarboxylic acid cycle is operated in the mitochondria. So the correct option over here is mitochondria. Question number 11. The cyclic reaction of tricarboxylic acid cycle was discovered by. You will see over here. First option is Sir Jacob Parnas, Sir Gustav Ebden and Sir Hans Krebs. All of the above. First two options you will see that they have discovered the cycle. They have discovered tricarboxylic acid cycle. But the cyclic reactions were studied by Sir Hans Krebs and for that he was awarded the Nobel Prize. So your third option is the correct one. Question number 12. Proteins, insulin, trypsin are obtained from amino acids are present in. You know insulin is a hormone which is secreted by the pancreas. Correct? Pituitary gland also secrete different hormones, but over here you will see the correct answer is pancreas. The third option over here is the correct one. Question number 13. Which of the following is not part of mitosis? You know the different phases of mitosis. The first one is prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, then cytokinesis, that is the division of the cytoplasm. Which is not a part, not a part. Please read the question properly, children. Over here they have asked which of the following is not a part. So answer over here is diplotene, the second option. It is not the part of the mitosis. Question number 14. Which of the following vitamin is essential for the synthesis of NADH2? Over here you will see the options. Option 1, vitamin B3, second option vitamin C, vitamin B2 and fourth option is vitamin K. Answer for this question is the first option, vitamin B3 is required or it is essential for the synthesis of NADH2. Question number 15. Each and every substance in dash is necessary to conduct various activities in our body. First option is vitamins, proteins, carbohydrates and all of the above. Each and every substance in it, you will see that vitamins are very very important, they are very essential and each vitamin is equally important for our body. So the option, the correct answer over here is vitamins, option 1. Question number 16. Each cell contains dash percent water by weight. You know that water is very very essential. So each and every cell contain water, our body also contain water. What is the percentage of water that is present in cell? 70% of water is present, 80% of water is present, 90% of water is present or 65% of water is present. So the correct answer over here is 70% of water is present in the cell. 70% of water. We are talking about the cell, in one cell, not whole body. got it? So the percentage of water, 70%. Question number 17. Before any type of cell division, the cell dash its chromosome number present in its nucleus. It triples up. First option is it triples up. Second is four times up. Third option is doubles up. And fourth option is all of the above. You will see over here, during the cell division, before any type of the cell division takes place, the cell double up its chromosome number. So it the answer over here, it doubles up its chromosome number present in its nucleus. Option number 3 is the correct answer. Question number 18. In case of plants, dash is formed exactly along the midline of the cell and thus cytokinesis is completed. Cytokinesis means the division of cytoplasm. If you remember, in the animal cell, a notch is formed which will deepen and then divide the cytoplasm into two cells. Nuclear membrane, this on its own it gets eliminated. Cell plate, yes, cell plate is formed when the, in the case of the plant cell, a cell plate is formed and then the cell gets divided into two cells. So the correct answer over here is option C, the cell plate. Got it? Option C, the cell plate. Question number 19. The cytoplasm divides by dash and two new daughter cells are formed. The cytoplasm, the process by which the cytoplasm divides into two is called as cytokinesis. So over here, the first option is the correct answer. Option 1, cytokinesis. Cytoplasm divides by the process of cytokinesis. Mitosis is essential for, you know, in the mitosis is a type of cell division. In mitosis only the body cell or the somatic cells, they get divided and new cells are formed. So if restoration of body is required, then also mitosis takes place. If the wound is to be healed, then also mitosis takes place. For the formation of new bloods also, you will see that mitosis is essential. So your correct answer over here is fourth option, all of the above. Question 21, protein located in bones is dash. First one, myosin. Second one, melanin. Third one, hemoglobin. And fourth one is osin. Now myosin, you know, it is a protein which is present in muscles. Second option is melanin, which is present in the skin, or it is a pigment which is related to the skin. Third one is hemoglobin. It is present, the pigment, this protein is located or it is present in the blood. The fourth option, that is osin, is the correct option. So your answer over here is option 4, osin. Question 22, dash cells divide by mitosis. Mitosis, you know that cell division is of two types. First one is mitosis, second one is meiosis. Mitosis takes place in the somatic and the stem cell, and meiosis will take place in the gametes, that is the sperms and ovum. So over here your correct answer is option 4, both 1 and 3, that is somatic cells and the stem cells. So somatic cells and stem cell divide by the process of mitosis. Question 23. The first step of karyokinesis is, that is the first step which is involved in the division of nucleus is. So you know there are different steps. First one is the prophase. Second one is the metaphase. Third one is the anaphase. Fourth one is the telophase. So which one is the correct answer? First step. The first step is the prophase. So your correct option is option number 4, prophase. Question 24. We get dash of energy per gram of lipid. So options over here are 4 calories per gram, second option 9 calories per gram, third option 9 kilocalories per gram, and the fourth one is 4 kilocalories per gram. Answer over here is the third option, 9 kilocalories per gram. With this, children, we have completed the MCQs. So I hope this session will help you, and this session or this part of this session will help you in appearing for your CET exam. Thank you, children, for joining this session.